Everybody, it's IKK Sox Reviews. We are back in another video, and guys, this will be the spoilers and speculations talk for Hawkeye episode 3. We're going to be talking about, you know, some of my theories and speculations and what's going to be probably happening going forward in this series. First and foremost, the first thing, you know, I speculated and I theorized is my theory of, you know, Eleanor of in the time where Battle of New York was going on. We see, before that starts happening, we see, Kate's father, Derek, and we see, of course, Eleanor talking about them selling the house. And I think, well, Derek's the one that's really saying we need to sell the house. And I'm thinking that Eleanor was into some bad stuff. And that's why she ends up killing, you know, Kate's father, is that he's into some bad things. And it seems like she might be a part of it. I'm thinking either A, she could be a part of some of these bad, you know, dealings that maybe the father is doing, that apparently to keep the penthouse. Or maybe I'm thinking she's involved and he just wants to sell it and get away from it and get away from all the stuff that's happening. And I think that's why, because it's weird to me is that they had money problems, hence why they had to sell the penthouse, because dealings weren't working. And that's why I'm thinking that maybe she got so angry and jealous of the fact that her daughter, Kate, had more of a connection to the father. And it seems like, you know, maybe that could be a reason. And also, like, maybe since the dealings weren't going through, because maybe he was holding her back in a sense. Because my theory is that Eleanor kills Derek when the events of the Battle of New York are going on, because we see her saying she was going to go downstairs to give her father, you know, give, you know, her father, you know, Kate's father some food, you know, Derek some food. And then we see, you know, Kate go upstairs, and out of nowhere, when, you know, the Battle of New York is going on, Kate's running around saying, you know, mommy, daddy, what's, you know, where are you? And I'm thinking definitely Eleanor is very sus, and she seems bitter about, you know, Derek having more of a connection with their daughter than she does. And also what's going on, she seems angry that, you know, they're selling the place and everything. She just seems frustrated and angry. So I'm thinking that she killed, you know, Derek. I'm thinking that's what's happened. She used the Battle of New York as a cover. And then, so I like how she went from not, you know, them not making enough money to sell the place, and then she ends up being in charge of, you know, Bishop Security. And, you know, and ends up, you know, being engaged to, you know, to Jack, you know, Duquesne, aka Swordsman. And, you know, she is, you know, communicating with, you know, Jack Duquesne's, you know, uncle, you know, Armand and stuff like that. So it's crazy in how Armand thinks of, you know, Eleanor as like a gold digger. And, you know, and it seems like, you know, when we catch, you know, Eleanor talking to Armand in the back room and Kate overhears, you know, it seems like, you know, Armand's like, you don't want to mess with me and all that stuff like that. And then we see that big break-in that happens at the auction, like the shady auction downstairs. It seems like I'm thinking Eleanor is a big crime boss right now, hence that she actually made that auction downstairs while this, you know, the normal auction was upstairs, but she's using, or the banquet's upstairs, but she's using the, you know, the crime, you know, auction, you know, for her crime side of things downstairs in the basement. Because I'm thinking, since she owns this big security company now, she probably has the ins with Fisk and everything and a whole bunch of other people, or if not Fisk, a whole bunch of other different crime syndicates around, you know, the world, or maybe just New York. And she is, you know, she has this, you know, front of her doing these charity auctions and everything, but she's behind the scenes doing all these bad things. But it all starts, I feel like, when she killed off, you know, Kate's father, Derek. And it seems like she has built up this organization ever since then, from not having any money to having all this money, owning, you know, of course, having, you know, Bishop Security, and, you know, having all this technology and keeping the fancy, penthouse that looks like she just fixed up after the Battle of New York. It looks like the same place. And it's just very weird to me that all this is going on now. And the fact of that this shady auction was going on downstairs, and then we end up having the fact of, you know, Jack's there with Armand, and they're trying to bid for the Ronin sword and the Ronin suits there, and apparently a watch to the Avengers compounds there. It seems like a lot of Avengers compound stuff is there, and the shady dealings of everybody in New York and the crime of syndicate of New York. And it seems like Armand is a sword, Jack is a sword collector, hence why he would want the Ronin sword, and he is swordsman. And we still don't know if, of course, Eleanor knows that, you know, Jack is swordsman and knows his knows that he's very skilled with swords. You know, we see, you know, again, Kate trying to figure out things of, you know, as Jack is sus and trying to figure out that, you know, he's hiding things and that he is more, you know, he is more than meets the eye and doesn't know if, you know, Eleanor knows that he's lying about being, you know, an excellent swordsman and everything. And she tests him through, you know, episode 2 of trying to figure out, you know, what's his deal, what's his play, because she thought it was very weird that, you know, at this point, you know, Kate doesn't know if Eleanor is into all the sus things, because when, you know, Eleanor walks out of, you know, talking to Armand and says, you know, you don't know what I'm capable of, she thinks that, you know, Armand was, you know, threatening her mother, and she always promised to protect her mother after her father died, even though I think, again, Eleanor killed, you know, Derek, you know, her actual father. I think, you know, she killed, you know, Kate's father. And it's just crazy that, you know, she thinks of, you know, Eleanor as this, you know, as this innocent person, innocent mother that's, you know, that would never hurt anybody, but I think she did kill her father, Kate's father. So it's interesting to know the fact that she goes down there thinking, oh, you know, I have to protect my mother from Armand and protect my mother from Jack. They're very weird. There's something going on there. And Jack ends up bidding for the sword, but, you know, we end up seeing the crashing of the tracksuits come in, and they're looking for the Avengers compound watch, which makes no sense to me what the watch contains. I'm thinking it could be maybe, you know, since we all know, you know, by this episode of episode 3 that the tracksuits answer to someone always above. And it's happened ever since back in the time where we had, you know, Echo's father being in charge of the Draculas or the tracksuits. So they're going by the tracksuit mafias, but they were the tracksuit Draculas in the comics. But they haven't said that. They go by the tracksuit mafia. So it's crazy to me that, you know, we know now that Kingpin is in charge of the tracksuits because he always has different organizations and stuff. And we end up seeing a little hint to him. We saw Vincent D'Onofrio in a sense, but we didn't see his full form. We saw, you know, him wearing his black suit sleeve, and we heard his voice. At least I heard his voice. So that is enough, knowing that we will get to see Vincent D'Onofrio's full form probably at episode 6 at the end, or just in episode 6, but I think it'll be at the end of episode 6, because I feel like that's something leading in. They want to really hone in into the Echo series of seeing him more, Vincent D'Onofrio more. So I feel like we'll see him in full form at the end of episode 6. I think that's when we'll see him. But we know he's in it, though, and he's involved of being the head honcho of the tracksuits. But he put Echo in charge because that is his adoptive daughter after the father died at the hands of Ronan back in the day when she was, you know, still learning out, you know, still trying to, like, at this point, I think she knows her father's in crime because she's grown now. She ends up going to the warehouse that the tracksuits are at and sees Ronan killing everybody and ends up seeing Ronan kill her father before Ronan dips out the window and ends up putting her in charge after her father dies. But we even saw the connection that, you know, Kingpin had, to Echo's father. Hence why, you know, he probably did that as a favor because of how her father died and wants to take her in as a favor to how he served, you know, how, you know, Echo's father served him as being the one in charge of the tracksuits, but now puts her in charge. And also, in general, if not that way, he wants to always have somebody that, you know, he can manipulate, because Fisk is always a manipulator. He did it with Poindexter. He does it with everybody. And, you know, we really see him manipulating people, and he's manipulating Echo, because I feel like that it's not a coincidence that Ronan was able to find that place. Apparently, he even said, you know, Clint says in this episode, in episode 3, that he went to the head boss, and the head boss sent him to, to the tracksuits, he went to the head boss and went to the shipments of where everything was coming from, at the tracksuits, you know, at headquarters. So it's like he sent Ronan all the way to the tracksuit warehouse saying, oh, that's where all the stuff is going down, I'm not involved or whatever. That's what they made it sound like. And hence, that's how he was able to find it. And that's how, you know, Echo's father died, is because of Fisk. And it's going to be interesting because I feel like we're going to be getting that, you know, maybe Clint explaining that to Echo, maybe by the end, maybe by episode 6 or something, he explains that to her or something. I'm not sure. Or maybe that will be her to find out in the Echo series that it was actually Fisk that was behind the death of her father, and is the reason that Ronan killed her father. So she has no, she can be mad at Ronan, but she is initially mad at Fisk for point, like, you know, pointing the, you know, the, you know, Ronan at her father when it was that, you know, when her father was doing Fisk's bidding. And it's going to be very interesting to see that go down. I wonder if she'll find that out in the series or find out in her series. I feel like she'll find out in her series because it'll show a lot of growth, because we know that she's not just a straight up villain. We know that, you know, she, you know, her, you know, her father wasn't all bad. Her father just, you know, it seems like he just wanted to do, like, do this stuff for the, do stuff for, you know, his daughter. And it just seems like, you know, he was just in the bad bad mindset and the bad business and ended up dying and worked for a bad person to support his daughter. And then he ends up dying and all that stuff. And she just doesn't seem like she's just a villain. She seems like she'll be an anti-hero, you know, her from just what the story we're getting and how she's acting. It seems like she'll become an anti-hero. So it's very interesting to me. Where her character is going to be going, because it seems like, you know, she just, you know, wants to, you know, just get, you know, revenge for her father's death. Like, she just wants, she feels, you know what I mean? It just, like, seems she's like, she's just a lost girl that wants, you know, revenge for her father. It seems like she doesn't want to cause harm on anybody. It looks from what I'm seeing, it should just be interesting to see where her character goes. It seems like she has a version of, like, how Matt, like, he has, sometimes he lets the devil out. It seems like she has a version of a devil within herself, and it's going to be interesting. Maybe we'll see that in her series of her, you know, she went, like, you know, but, you know, she was so overwhelmed with, you know, anger and, you know, hate for Ronan. She ended up just choking Kate, thinking it was Ronan. And I feel like we'll see that go on maybe into her series of her just being angry and wanting revenge. And maybe we'll see. And then, because she'll, by the end of this, I know she's going to be wanting to go after Fisk. I feel like she'll find out and want to go after Fisk going into her series. And I feel like that's how Matt is so good in play, where Matt to come in, Matt Murdock, is so good, because he wanted to kill Fisk. He wanted revenge on Fisk at the end of season 3 of Daredevil. He beat the crap out of him and wanted to take him out. But he didn't do it. He said, I'm not going to let you ruin who I am. You're going to go back to prison, or I'll go after your wife. Like, you're going to go back to prison. And that goes to show, if, I don't know if the MCU is going to take some continuity of having Vanessa, you know, and what happened, the events of, you know, season 3 of Daredevil, where it's like, goes back to prison. He, you know, he won't go after Vanessa. You know what I mean? Like, what is going to happen? Eventually, I feel like if they are going to, they are going to do the continuity of, okay, it's been 5 years, he probably got out, maybe people blipped out, and he got out, let out of prison, who knows, you know what I mean, like, maybe he got blipped, you know, everybody blipped out, he got out of prison, you know, by himself, or maybe he was let out of prison because there wasn't enough people, and they let prisoners out. I don't know what could happen. Maybe I feel like people blipped, and that's how he just got out, he just, like, broke out, or maybe people blipped out, and he got let out. Who knows what they're going to be doing with that, if they take any continuity from whatever, but or maybe he didn't get blipped at all. We don't know until they start really laying the groundwork of what's happening. So it's very interesting to know if Wilson Fisk got blipped or not, or if he didn't get blipped, how did he get out of prison? But that's if only they go with the continuity of he got put in prison from season 3 of Daredevil. So it's interesting to know what they're going to be taking from Netflix's Daredevil, what continuity and what storylines and what they're going to be putting in here, because it also goes to show that what they're going to take for Matt Murdock's, you know, Charlie Cox, Matt Murdock / Daredevil's continuity from his series on to here. And so, where's Matt been all those years? We don't know. You know, I've had, you know, speculations of how they could be doing it with Matt's character and how, like, you know, he didn't get blipped, but Foggy and Karen did. Hence why he chose to be Daredevil again after people blipped, and he felt the blame that it was his fault because he didn't do anything all that time, and he felt like it was his fault that everybody blipped and he lost his friends. And that would put him and spiral him back into being Daredevil, and that would be cool to see him go forward in the MCU if that's what they would explain. Like, they blipped out and he just wanted to be Daredevil again because he thought it was his fault. And it would be cool to see him do all that stuff, and that's how he became Daredevil again, because as we all know, at the end of season 3, he's not Daredevil anymore. He chose to be, you know, a part of, you know, Paige, Nelson, and Murdock. He chose to be a part of that and leave the Daredevil, that side of Daredevil behind, leave that side of him behind. So it's interesting to see why, if they took anything from there, what made him want to be Daredevil again? Is he not Daredevil and he's just like, you know what I mean? Or they're just going to like reboot it by have, you know, Charlie Cox as Daredevil and just have him have that other side? We don't know yet. It's very interesting to see what they're going to be, what they're going to take and what they're going to not take from the Netflix universe of Daredevil. So it's just going to be interesting to see, because also, as we all know, with Echo's character, there's a lot, I feel like by the end of this, she's going to want to go after Wilson Fisk, because I feel like Hawkeye's, you know, Clint's going to tell her that, you know, I was sent to go do that to the tracksuits, so, you know, and she's going to realize it was Kingpin, and she's going to be going after him into her, in her series, and wanting to kill him. And I feel like, but I feel like in that series, Matt's going to want to put him away, and she's going to want to kill him, and she's going to have to, like, he's going to have to, like, train her to, like, killing's not the right way, don't let him ruin who you are. And we're going to see that dynamic in the series, because Matt's been through it. He's been wanting to kill Wilson Fisk. He's been wanting to, he's thought about, you know, taking him off, you know, the leaderboard and not using the right way to put people away, using, you know, the law. He's thought about using the other side by just killing people off. And, but he's learned that I'm not going to let you ruin who I am. But I would just, that's why I wish they would take that continuity over, because it would really show that Echo isn't the killer. She just wants revenge for her father. As we're seeing that, she's being manipulated by Wilson Fisk. And Matt knows people that have been manipulated by Wilson Fisk. Matt knows how it feels like to want to kill, Wilson Fisk. But he hasn't done that, because it would change who he is. And I feel like it would be such a cool storyline to go through in that series of showing that there's a better way, there's a better thing, a way to do things. But it's going to be interesting what they do either or with the Echo series. I'm excited to see where they're going to be going with that character. So I'm super, super excited what they're going to be doing with their character going forward in the series, and what they're going to be doing with, you know, Matt Murdock in the series, because we all know we are going to be having the first appearance of Matt Murdock in No Way Home. And he's going to make appearances, of course, in She-Hulk, and then he'll probably be in the Echo series. I think it's going to be She-Hulk. He'll make some slight appearances because he's a lawyer. So is, of course, Jennifer Walters. And it's going to be interesting to see where all that's going to be going down. And, you know, him making his appearances. But it's going to set the groundwork, I feel like, for him to make his appearance in the Echo series. So it's going to be very interesting. Also, if she doesn't find out in this episode, in the series of that, you know, maybe he's the reason that, you know, Fisk is the reason that her father died, she'll probably find out in that series. Well, but before she finds out, I bet you Fisk is going to send out a hit on, you know, Matt Murdock. You know, for, you know, Echo, like, send out a hit, you know, send out Echo to kill Matt Murdock, or maybe to, maybe kill Karen Page, or something like that, I don't know, because in the comics, I think Wilson kills Karen Page, and sends in Echo to be, like, his love interest, and to get on the ends with Matt Murdock to make him put his guard down, so she can end up killing him, or Fisk can end up killing him, or something can end up happening. And, you know, that's when he finds out and ends up, you know, and then that's when he tells Echo something, and that's when Echo turns her back on Fisk, ends up, they both end up going after Fisk. So it's like, I feel like at the end of that series, we'll see it where, like, either leading into a series, she'll go after Fisk, running into Matt Murdock, or she won't know about her father yet. She'll get the hit order to go after, you know, Matt Murdock, and then he'll teach, you know, he'll tell her about how Fisk does things and whatever, and then they'll go after Fisk. Either way, it ends up all going after, she's going after Fisk. Either in this series, by the end of the series, or into her series, she's going to be going after him and turning her back on him, finding out about how maybe he had dealings of how her father died, of sending Ronan, to the tracksuits lair, and she's going to be angry. I'm just interested to see what they're going to be doing with her character, and we're going to be seeing that, because, we have 3 more episodes left, so we have a lot to still uncover with that character. But I'm just excited on what's going on, guys, of how this could all lead into play, and also going back to the watch, of why the tracksuits were there, because they even questioned that in episode 3 of this, called Echoes. They even questioned that in episode 3 of Hawkeye, of why were the tracksuits at the auction? They were getting a watch. What does that watch do? There's different theories I'm thinking of what the watch could do. It could be, you know, the watch, Tony had in Civil War, where it does, like, the flipping thing and it makes the gauntlet. It could be the watch, maybe, that they did all the time travel with all the Pym tech that they used to travel through time using the quantum realm. And we all know Quantumania is coming up. So it's like, what is this watch do? Or does it have access maybe to the Avengers compound and they want more stuff in there? It all leads back to what I keep thinking is that every MCU thing, whether it be the Spider-Man movies, whether it be the Iron Man movies, whether it be in general of anything, the biggest technology there is in the MCU, the only technology that everybody wants is Stark Tech. And I'm thinking that that's pretty much, you know, what they want. They want the Stark Tech. And what really makes me, curious is we all know that Vulture had a cleanup, Vulture was a part of a cleanup crew. What if that same cleanup crew, some of the members that are left or whatever, maybe that got out of jail in that time period from Homecoming, what if they're working with Fisk and they want that technology? Because remember, Fisk is in charge of the track suits. So what if he wants to sell all that, get the key to get into, you know what I mean, into the warehouse, into the place, to give them all that stuff or whatever? Or what if not, maybe the cleanup crew went there, got that stuff, gave it to the auction, Eleanor's auction, and maybe the tracksuits want to get in there, get the stuff, and give it to Kingpin. Maybe it's like, it's a battle for who's in charge of New York. Maybe it's Eleanor with her crime business, having her auction down below, selling all, they got all the stuff from the cleanup crew that we saw in, you know, Spider-Man Homecoming, and they sold the tech to Eleanor to sell off at auction, and maybe then when Fisk doesn't want to buy it, and he's like, I want you guys to break in there, take all the stuff, take the thing to get into the compound so we can get all the technology so I can sell it to different crime people. It's like the battle of crime in New York. It might be Eleanor versus Kingpin. That might be what's going down right now, and it's going to be interesting to see if that's what's happening. Is it like the battle of the crime syndicate in New York? Like, who's going to be the biggest crime boss? Because, I mean, already, like, Kate's, you know, mother, Eleanor, already has a big impact in New York. Her being Kate Bishop Security, which is a big thing in New York, it seems like. And she has a whole bunch of different clients, and some of them bad, as we clearly see from what it looks like from the computer. I'm thinking it is the battle of the crimes, hence why they broke the tracksuits, broke in, took that watch. Because maybe Fisk knew it was going to be there, and he wants to use it for whatever, and get money and make connections. I'm thinking that could be a possibility. I just don't know what the watch does. It seems like it might be a watch maybe to get into the compound, but is the compound still there after it got destroyed in Avengers Endgame? We don't know. Or maybe it leads into a hangar that has all like the tech in it from the compound. Samson Homecoming, we saw all the different warehouses that had Tony's tech in it. Maybe it leads to in one of those warehouses where Fisk can get a whole bunch of weapons and sell them to people. I mean, like, it could be that easy, that simple, where it's like he wants to take it for himself. He doesn't have to pay. He thinks he's the big bad, and he wants to pretty much leave a message to Eleanor saying, "I'm the head honcho. I'm just taking what I want because it's not yours. I'm the kingpin." And that might be a threat to Eleanor. Who knows? Maybe Armand was working with Fisk, and they are working on the other side of things, saying, "You don't know what I'm capable of." And maybe that Armand didn't literally say, "I'm working with Fisk," but maybe they knew it. Hence why, you know, Jack Duquesne kills Armand, because maybe he knows that he is working with Fisk. And maybe he knows that he is the reason that Fisk knew that Eleanor was doing the shady auction down below. You know what I mean? Like, who knows? I mean, those are my theories, guys. I really want to know down in the comments below what you guys think about my theories. And I want to know what your theories are down in the comments below about what could be happening. What could we be leading up to? You know, not just in this series, but leading into the Echo series. And also, like, another thing I thought of is that, when will Yelena come in? That's the question. I think she might be the end credit in episode 5 leading into 6. And I think there will be a fight between Echo and, you know, Hawkeye, and I think, I meant Echo and, you know, Kate Bishop, and I think there will be a fight between Hawkeye and Yelena, and I feel like that's when they'll explain to Yelena that, you know, "I didn't kill, you know, your sister, you know, I she was my partner, I cared for her, you know, this is what really happened, you know, Valentino's been lying to you, and maybe, you know, I took out some shady things that she's been doing, and that's maybe why she sent you after me." Like, I feel like, you know, Ronan's also taken out some of Valentina's connections, hence why Valentina is sending Yelena after, you know, Clint, aka Ronin. And it's weird that she's the only one that knows that Clint was the Ronin by the picture. So it's like, I think she had connections on the inn, and she's just doing this as like, I don't want to get my hands dirty. I want to make other people get their hands dirty. So I'm going to send a wild, card out there that wants revenge for her sister. And I'm going to say, oh, Ronin killed, you know, your sister. Go get him. Go kill him. Do my work for me. And I feel like she'll find that out, and she'll want to go after Yelena in future projects, because we're going to have a Young Avengers versus the I forget what they're called. They're called like it's the Young Avengers versus the something. It's like the opposite of the Avengers. It's the I'm trying to think right now on the top of my head. I'm gonna come back on and I'll say it. So like, I feel like we're leading up where they could be fighting up against like the Masters of Evil. You know, if they decide to be like the West Coast Avengers, they could be like the Young Avengers, but on the West Coast, because we know that they're building up, you know, they have Shang-Chi and, you know, and I forget the name of it right now, but we're in San Francisco, and we have, Ant-Man in San Francisco. I feel like there's so many like heroes building up in San Francisco that we really haven't seen an Avengers Tower anywhere else but in New York or upstate New York. So I'm thinking we could have the West Coast Avengers, aka the Young Avengers, in West Coast, in San Francisco. So there's just so many things that could happen. Or, you know what I mean? Because also we all know that the tower that's being built in New York, we think it's Oscorp Tower, or we think it's the Fantastic Four Tower. We don't know yet. So it's interesting to know. I think the home base will be in San Francisco, and I feel like they could fight again the Masters of Evil or the Thunderbolts, because we all know Thunderbolt Ross is going to be becoming Red Hulk soon. They're already hinting towards it with him being sick, and I feel like, you know, they're going to be building up towards that. And I feel like we need this new team of Avengers, which we're building up with, you know, Wicked and Speed from WandaVision, you know, Wanda's kids and Vision's kids. And we've been building up with young Loki, or, you know, Kid Loki. And then we've been building up with, of course, Yelena, and she'll be like the new Black Widow figure. And we're building up with Kate Bishop, which is like the new Hawkeye figure. And, you know, of course, with, you know, Eli Bradley, you know what I mean? You know, Isaiah Bradley's, you know, grandson. So I feel like we're building up our new Avengers team. I feel like we're building it up, or at least the Young Avengers, but also we're building up the other Avengers team, which is the main core Avengers team with Sam Wilson, the new Captain America, with Shang-Chi, with Doctor Strange, with Spider-Man, with, of course, Scarlet Witch still. I feel like, you know, with Wanda, I feel like we're going to have two Avengers teams, but I feel like they're building up the Thunderbolts against the Young Avengers. I feel like that's what we're building up to. Or, you know, again, Masters of Evil. I feel like we're building up to something, but I feel like for our Young Avengers, they need to fight something that's like the Thunderbolts. That's more of like a grounded level thing. I feel like our Avengers wouldn't be fighting, our heavy hitter Avengers main core would fight something like that. I feel like it'd be like the Young Avengers versus like the Thunderbolts, or like, I forget the other word for like the bad Avengers or something like that. But I feel like we're leading up to something like that. And I feel like that's what's going to be happening, and that's what we're going to be seeing in the future after we get everybody together. And I feel like we'll get everybody together because Tommy and Billy, as we all know, they're not real in Wanda's universe, but they're real in a different multiverse, which, aka Multiverse of Madness, will get Tommy and Billy to actually be real in our universe. And they will join, again, the Young Avengers. I feel like that's what we're building up to, guys. And I'm super excited to see what they're going to be doing with that. And I'm super excited to see, again, what if my theories are right and my speculations. I feel like they've been so far, because I told my sister, and I've said it in future videos, I think in the Daredevil video, I explained that maybe that's what's going on. Maybe I did it in the Black Widow video. I don't know where I did it, but I said that, you know, Ronan's taking out probably some people on Valentina's side, hence why, you know, she's sending out Yelena. I feel like he's taking out some people on, you know, Kingpin's side, hence why everybody's going after, you know, Ronan right now in the series. I feel like this is everybody, he's taking out so many people on the crime syndicate that everybody wants a piece of Ronan. And I feel like that's what we're getting in the series. And then, you know, I'm I can't believe it. I think I might have been right. So, and that's happy to have a theory or speculation that's right. And again, guys, that was a video. That's all pretty much all I have on the top of my head I can think of. But I want to know what your theories and speculations are of this series or of the Echo series or where we're building with like the Young Avengers. I really want to know what your theories are going forward of what's going to be happening in the series and what's going to be happening after this series. And again, if you're new to the channel, subscribe to the channel and put on those notifications. Like this video. Go check out my review of episode 3 of Hawkeye. It should be up right now, of episode 3 of Hawkeye, so go check that out, my spoiler review. And then, of course, guys, if you guys check this out, this is my, like, speculations and theories review of what is possibly going to be happening. I'm just loving what's going on with the series. I'm loving what's going on with the MCU. I love how this universe keeps building and building, and it keeps getting interesting, and it keeps growing, and it's literally like the comic books. Like, it's an everlasting universe, and different multiverses colliding with one another, or just being different, and this universe is just so big. And I love how Kevin is making it just like the comics. We have so many characters. This universe is growing each and every day. Literally, we do that each and every year with different movies and shows, and I'm loving it. Some people are hating it. I'm loving how this universe is building. It keeps it fresh. It keeps it new, and I'm loving it. But guys, that was a video. Again, if you're new to the channel, subscribe to the channel, put on those notifications, like this video. I'd love to have you guys here, part of this family. We're on our way to hitting 500 subscribers. So again, I would just love it again if you subscribe to the channel, put on those notifications, and like this video. Come join the fam. But guys, that was a video. I hope everybody has a great day, a safe day. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.